Greetings. This is Ashahed Muhammad with thefinalcall.com news, and I'm here at 26th Street in California in Chicago, Illinois, at the Cook County Jail, where we are awaiting the possible release of Victor Safforld, also known as Cortez Brown. If any of you have been regular readers of The Final Call, you know that we followed stories of members of the Chicago Police Department under the infamous police commander Jon Burge, who tortured young men, young black men, and forced them to sign confessions for murders that they didn't commit. Leroy Orange, Madison Hobley, Daryl Cannon, the list goes on and on. Well, we are here today because after 20 plus years, Victor Safforld is prepared to walk out of the doors of Cook County Jail, out of the bars and the gates of Cook County Jail, as a result of evidence that came to light when he told the police department that he was forced to sign a confession. Here we have brother, the National Prison Reform Minister, brother Minister Abdullah Muhammad, who is here. Brother Abdullah, assalamu alaikum. Good to see you. Brother Abdullah Muhammad is the National Prison Reform Minister of the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan in the Nation of Islam. And he has led the charge to insist that not only Victor Safforld, Cortez Brown, was freed, but he has also been a voice of justice and those who languish behind bars all across the United States of America because of torture by members of police departments across the United States. Minister Abdullah, how do you feel today walking in here, possibly preparing for the freedom of a brother that you have talked to and counseled, Victor Safforld?
I feel real good about it because Minister Farrakhan assigned me to represent him here at the county jail by teaching religious services, or the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Victor was one of the brothers that when I would come, I didn't know him, but when I would come, him and another brother would always be there to set the rostrum up, the chairs up, and I didn't know what he was in prison for. All I knew, I was familiar with his face and his work to set up the chapel whenever we had service. As time went on, he wound up getting the death penalty, and I supported him the best way I can as a representative of Minister Farrakhan by being in court. And he fought, he appealed the death penalty, and then I think it was 1995, they reimposed the death penalty for a second time. At that time, I thought it was over with because I'm not familiar with the process. But he kept fighting, and we kept supporting him by putting on forums in the community, dealing with torture and police brutality. And at some point in time, which I can't be right and exact, I believe it was Sister Sanji, who used to be a secretary of Minister Farrakhan, probably brought it to his attention. And from that point on, Minister Farrakhan became interested in the case, and then he began to support him. Yes. And in fact, Minister Farrakhan gave me the bond money to come here today to bond Cortez Brown out. And when Cortez was on death row, he used to set up telephone calls where I could teach the men on death row via telephone. And right now, I teach in Stateville on Mondays, and some of those men from death row are in this class, and they all remain steadfast and consistent.
Yes.
I don't know what they do when I'm gone, but they're consistent about studying and being in class. Mm-hmm. So basically, I'm happy.
Yes, sir.
And it confirms to me that Minister Farrakhan is divinely guided, because whoever he decides to support, Allah works it all out, and eventually victory comes to the believer or the apostle or the anointed servant of God.
Now, they're asking questions, of course, regarding Brother Victor Safforld's religious conversion in prison. And for the record, you have are in a position to confirm that he, in fact, is a follower of the Honorable Louis Farrakhan and a member of the Nation of Islam.
Well, last time I was here, Minister Farrakhan just said we're his spiritual advisors.
Okay, all right.
So that's what I'm saying.
All right, that's right. And today...
And Minister Farrakhan told me there is no compulsion in religion, and he could join the Nation of Islam if he want to, or he don't have to. There's no compulsion in religion.
So right now, we're getting ready to go in and pay the final bond money. Why is it necessary to pay a bond right now for Victor? Can you go into that a little bit?
Because Brother Victor's out date was today, the 21st of September. What happened is, in the process leading up to his out date, Victor say the guards jumped on him. And he said that then the guards turned around and pressed charges against him. Then they gave him a $25,000 bond, which means he had to come up with $2,500 in cash. And so he came to court today to deal with his release date and the bond money and the new court date. So when he gets out, he has another court date. And I don't want to say what the date is because I forgot, but he has another court date, so he got to return to fight this case now that the guards charge him with jumping on them.
All right. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Thank you.